Hello and welcome to SAP on Microsoft Azure. My name is Holger Bruchelt, and in this video series we want to take a look behind the scenes of the Extending SAP Solutions Using Microsoft Power Platform webinar. This is Chapter 4, where we will concentrate on Power Automate, starting from an incoming email, which could have an invoice attached. To it, we will trigger a Power Automate flow, which will then loop over the attached PDF, use the form recognizer from the AI builder, and extract relevant information. In our case, since our SAP system has a beautiful list of products, we will look for products. Then we will create these products in the SAP system. So the actual flow is pretty straightforward. We have Outlook, we have a trigger in Power Automate that listens to incoming emails. We will use the forms processing engine from the AI builder to extract the information in the PDF document. Then we'll use the custom connector to create these products in our SAP system. The flow that we're going to create in the end is fairly complex, or it has a good complexity, I would say. So we'll have the incoming trigger for the email. We loop over all the attachments that we have. We have the forms recognizer that then extracts the information from the PDF document. We'll have an adaptive card that is sent to Teams for the approval step. And then as a final step, we'll create the product in the SAP system. In this first video, we'll only concentrate on the upper half here. So we'll create the trigger for Outlook, and we'll train the model for our forms recognizer to be able to extract the relevant information from our PDF document. So we are here in Power Automate. There are multiple templates available that get me started, but what I want to start with is actually this AI builder. As you might remember, we need the AI builder to extract the content from the incoming PDF documents. Now, in order to do this, we have a functionality called the Forms Recognizer. This Forms Recognizer is a pre-trained, pre-built model that allows me to provide some sample scenarios, some sample PDF documents, and then use this as a foundation to extract the relevant content. So I select here the Forms Processing functionality, and I give my new model a name, so like Product Extraction. If I click on Create, then I need to upload a few sample documents. So what I've already done, I've created quite a few sample Word documents or PDF documents in the end, where I moved around the layout, where I have different tables and stuff like that created. So this will be our foundation to actually train this specific model. But before we go there, I need to say, well, look, I'm looking for a table in my PDF document. We can give this table a certain name. I'll just leave it default as table one. And now I can specify the properties that I'm looking for. So definitely I need to have the product ID. I need to have the description of my specific product. And I need the price of this specific product. And then finally, what I also need is obviously the name of this specific product. So in all the documents that we'll now process, I will be looking for a table called table one and these four properties that should be somewhere within this PDF document. So as a next step, I need to create this collection where I'll upload all these sample documents that I've created. So here, for example, you can see the table at the bottom. There's a to and from field. At the top, then we have another one where the to and from is a different settings on this page. Again here, then we have a few where the table is different, where there are different properties and stuff like that. So all I'm doing now is I'm just uploading this content from my local drive into the Power Platform, into this AI Builder functionality here. So I'll upload these 9 documents. They are quickly analyzed, whether they fit, whether they are really unique, so there are no duplications and stuff like that. And then I can actually get started in selecting the areas where we have the relevant content. Keep in mind, I mean, we're right now just using the forms doc, forms recognizer, but there's no idea of what the form is actually for and what is the content that we're looking for. So here what I can do is I can just select the table. You can see the forms recognizer already said, well, this looks like a table. So I say, yes, that's really the table, and we'll use table one that I previously defined. And now I can go to the actual properties. So here I can select, for example, the product ID. That's the first one. Then the forms recognizer identified another one. So table or name, description, pricing, and the comments field, for example. So we'll just leave this out. So this is what I'll do for all the next document. And you can see it, even with this very first document, it already was able to detect the table and to also detect the fields that are really relevant for me. So I'll just go over all these 9 documents. And obviously, if I have more documents, this would increase the accuracy of detecting all these different fields. But here it's just, we just see the table and we see the different fields that are detected automatically. So I'll just finish this by going through all the 9 documents. And then we're actually done in creating this first collection. So with this, we're at the last document, document 9, and I can just click on next to actually complete the creation of the whole collection. Now we are ready to train our model. So we have these 4 fields: product ID, description, price, and name. These are the entries that we're looking for in our models. And if I click on train, then it takes a few minutes, but then the training should be completed. And now you would, for example, be able to test and do a quick test with this model. When you do this, just upload another PDF document, make sure that you have everything in place. But then if you're fine, then again, just publish the model. Again, it takes some time to really finally publish this scenario. But then that's it, and you're ready to go. Now you have a trained product extraction model as part of the AI builder, which we'll use in our Power Automate flow in a second to actually retrieve the values from an incoming PDF document. So how do we start with Power Automate? Well, we could start with one of the templates, but what we want to do is we'll just use this instant flow where I just provide this with a name. So extract product and create SAP and create an SAP. I could select one of these trigger points, but I'll just leave it like this and start really from scratch. So the first thing that we need to do is define this trigger point. And as mentioned, we want to have a trigger from Outlook. And you can see there are a lot of different triggers available, but I'll select the when a new email arrives. So this specific Power Automate flow should only start when an email arrives. I have linked already this email to my user, so it really monitors my specific user. I'll put in some properties here. I'll say that, first of all, include attachments. So I really want to take a look at the attachments. And then in the next step, I'll start to look at these PDF documents. So as part of the AI builder, there's a functionality to retrieve our forms builder. So this process and save information from forms. We'll select this one. We'll select the AI model that we just created. So the product extraction, we specify the form type, which is this PDF document that we have. So you can see there are some others available. And then we'll select as an input document, we'll select the PDF document or the attachment from the previous step. Now, as you will see in a second, since there could be multiple attachments, there's immediately this apply to each functionality applied. So now for each and every PDF document that is part of this email, we'll run the forms recognizer. So let me just put another name in here again, and then let's click on save to test out this flow. So now if I send an email to the specific user, a PDF document ideally, then this flow will be triggered, and the process and save information flow, this trigger point, will be started. So I'll just actually log into my own email. So the user Johnny Sherman will send an email to himself, so just a test, and we'll attach one of our PDF documents that has this product information in place. So we'll just use this one here and send it to ourselves. So this very same email will arrive in our inbox in a second. There it is already. So yeah, all is fine. The interesting thing here is that now the Power Automate flow is triggered. So if we go back here, you can already see the flow has been started, and actually it already succeeded. It already completed. So if we click here, then we see, yes, the email was received. The Power Automate flow got triggered. And now we can actually take a look at this, at the results of our document processing. So you can see something happened. There was a table retrieved, and there are even some columns there. If we look at one of the tables, we can actually search, for example, for the price. And we can see the value 1000, which is part of our PDF document, or the product ID, which is also part of this table. All of this information is there. There's also this confidence score, which shows me how confident Power Automate is, or the AI builder is, that this is really the valid value. And with this, obviously, we now have the foundation to continue and build our Power Automate flow in a way that not only the information is extracted from the PDF document, but then also in the next step that this information can be written to the SAP system.